Yeah, my name is Abdullah Yusuf. I am 31 years old. I am from Somalia. I am in Netherlands between 5.5 years. And they put me in Strat two times. The first time was in 2009. They put me in jail for 2 weeks. After that, they put me in the street. And I will say I was in the street 1 year and a half. And after that, I go back to Trapol, and they send me to SSA Centrum. And after 1 year, they put me in street again. And I try to do another Azil Anfrag, and they put me in the street again. So I was now in the street for the two time for 8 months. The situation in Somalia is very bad. In Somalia, we have too many problems. Number one is a Shabab group is connected with Al-Qaeda group. They are extremist Islamist group. We have also the pirates. We have Lord War. We have tribal problem. We have female. We have very weak government. We have too many problems in Somalia. If Somali people in Netherlands can go back to Somalia, if they we go back to Somalia, we have to otherwise join Al-Shabaab, or otherwise join the pirates to live, because there is no other solution to live.
And what is Shabaab?
Al-Shabaab is an extremist Islamist group that they are controlling the almost the north, the south side of Somalia, almost south side of Somalia. They are connected with Al-Qaeda.
You were also in Trapol, yeah? What was the camp for, how it happened and how it went and how it ended? Could you explain your experience?
I hear about the camp from one friend. He's in the street also. He told me they are preparing for a protest in front of IND in trouble. And I said, okay. And I tell my friends I know in the street. We're collecting people, and there is Iraqi people, they're starting this protest. After that, we are coming, Somali people. We are staying there for 15 days in 23 of May. The police come and take us from there by force. We are almost 107 people from Somalia. We are all the people there, between 350 people, 400 people, minus 400 people. The people of Iraq, they agree with the government. There is a minister. It's coming 15 June from Iraqi government. He will come to the government I don't know what the deal they taking with it. So the IND, they told us to take the deal they take with the Iraqi people. We told us that Iraq is another country, the Somali people. We have to see our situation. They told us, no, you have to move from here. We told them we can't move because we don't have any place to go. They told us, no, you have to move. The IND and the Burgomaster of Trapol and the Kawa, they are all told us to move from Trapol. And when we refuse, they bring a police and the MA, the military group, and the commanders group with dogs to us, and they take us by force. We have a pregnant woman. We have 3 pregnant women. We have sick people. We have people sick with heart. We have sick people with blood pressure. We have people sick with soccer. We have an old people. We have a woman. It was at 18 years old. Big woman. 80 years old, as a big woman. So they come, they don't care about this all. They come, they use the big power, they use the force to take us. We have too many people injured now. I am injured of the neck. One police guy, he's put his leg on my neck. I can move it now like this.
Why he did it?
Like this. He put his leg, throw me in the floor, and he put his legs on my neck.
Why he did it?
Well, I don't know why he did it. He wanted to take me by force, and he put me in the floor, and he put his leg on my neck. Now I have a problem. I can move my neck. I can't do like this. We have too many people are now injured. We have one guy, he lost his teeth. We have one guy, he's broken his hand. We have one guy, he's broken his finger. The people, we have too many people, they are screaming when they sleep. They have nightmare. They have bad dreams. They dream about the police. They make a very bad thing for us. We lost our stuffs. We lost our mobiles. We lost our bags. So
this for some people, it was everything what they you have.
Yeah, yeah. For some people, they have only one bag for the. Mm-hmm. They lost their bag. They don't have nothing. They don't have mobile.
What did they? Did they just throw it to the garbage or?
I don't know what they did. The police take it and they told us we don't know. We look for it. And we ask again. They told us we don't know. We look for it, and we don't know. And they tell us, and they threw us to three camps. They put us in jail before, in Groningen, for one night, and the other day, they separate us into three places. One group, our group, they put us in Arnhem, and the other group, they put us in Borchum, in Friesland, and other group, they put us in Vught, in Den Bosch. They told us, you will stay 3 weeks, only 3 weeks in these camps. After that, we don't know what's happening. I think we will throw us again in the street. So I don't know what the government want to do. So we hope the organization and the normal people, we ask them for help.
How normal people and organizations can help you?
We can. They can help us by make a pressure to the government to do a solution to our people. Our Somali people, they have too much problem. The court of Netherlands said that nobody can bring back to Somalia. The court for Netherlands said, the Raad van State for Netherlands said that. I don't know what the minister, he don't listening to his own court. He refused the own court, what he said. I don't understand that. So I don't know what we have to do. We just need help.
Mm-hmm. And what other kind of help you need?
We need support. Uh-huh. We need support from people. We need support from organization. We need them to help us if we gonna protest again. If they make us protest again, we don't know if they make us or not. We need support from them. Like some people support us from the beginning. But now we need more support, because if we do this again, we need to show the Netherlands government and the world that we have, there is a serious problem here. There is a human crisis here in Netherlands. They're always talking about the economic crisis in Europe. But now in Netherlands, there is a human crisis. There is maybe 20,000 people in the street. There is maybe 5,000 Somali people in the street. This is not possible. How could these people live? What they want us to do? They are human beings. We are human beings. We want a human right. We just want human right. We don't want big thing. We ask for small thing. We ask for life, decent life. The IND told us that we will stay in the camp for only 3 weeks. After 3 weeks, we don't know what's happening. They told us until 15 June, we will stay in the camp. After 15 June, if they don't give us a solution, a good solution to solve this problem, we have to go back to where we started. You have to make protest again. Anywhere. Mm-hmm. We want to make it anywhere. Mm-hmm. Den Haag, in Amsterdam. Or in same place we make before mm-hmm. trouble.
Are you not afraid after your injuries and this what you went through?
No, I'm not afraid at all because I don't have nothing. I don't have nothing.
You have no other choice.
I don't have other choice. I have to do it again and again and again until they listen to us and do what they ask them to do. We ask them just to give us life. We don't ask for big things. We don't ask for huge things. We just ask for human life. So we'll do it again if they then listen to us. Thank you very much.